eventually later in the class today to practice some balancing. If we get to that point of class.
Once or twice more like that. Inhale.
part of the practice. It's really important to feel centered and grounded before we begin to move and connect with our body. We have to find that stillness and our center first. So if it feels right for you, go ahead and close down to the eyes. If that's not something you want to do right now, know that that's okay. And maybe just let your gaze, let the eyes soften. The eyelids can be heavy. And rest your gaze on one point in the room. Wherever your gaze just naturally lands, let it rest. Beginning by simply just bringing awareness to our breath. Noticing your body's natural rhythm, its pace. Feeling the breath, the inhale and the exhale. Where do you feel that breath in your own body? Get curious and explore. Any patterns or cycles of your breathing, and rest assured that there is no right or wrong. We're just bringing awareness right now. Slowly, we'll start to scan the body from the top of the head all the way down to the toes. Might look like you just naming body parts and moving through this on your own, letting them soften as you bring your attention there. If you'd like to follow along with me, we can start by noticing the top of the head. Can we reach that crown of the head up towards the sky, elongating the spine? And then bring your awareness into the face, the forehead particularly. Let it soften. The eyebrows and the space just in between the eyebrows. The eyes themselves are heavy. Feel the cheeks and the cheekbones softening. Both of the ears, hearing and listening to the whole body. Feel the nose, the tip of the nose, and both of the nostrils breathing together as one. Let the jaw unhinge. Let it rest and open naturally. The mouth as well. The neck and the shoulders soften down. Feel the nice relaxed state with us throughout the rest of our practice. So as we move forward together, I'll remind us to check in with our posture. Can we sit up a little bit taller? Can we breathe just a little bit deeper? With this foundation, we can deepen our entire practice. Very nice. Let's get moving here. So join me when you're ready. We're going to walk the hips one by one forward towards the edge of the chair. And then we'll walk them back. Once more like this, finding the front of our chair, we're going to stay here for a bit. So find that you are seated, your weight is shifted in a way that is stable here. So the reason for coming to the edge of the chair, for me in particular, is because I'm a little bit shorter. So coming to the edge, I can really rest both of my feet down and feel stable. So you'll notice that a lot of the poses that I'm about to do in the practice, I'll do them from the edge of my chair. But I'll invite you to do them in whatever way feels comfortable and best for your body. Very nice. Let's inhale, draw the shoulders up to the ears. Exhale, back and down. Moving through these shoulder rolls in your own time. And switching the direction of those circles whenever you feel called to. Very nice. Finding your way back to center. We'll let the left ear fall over the left shoulder. Let the head hang. Let it be heavy. And can we do this still with a straight spine sitting up nice and tall? Noticing our posture as we move throughout these poses. Taking a nice deep breath into the area of the right neck and the right shoulder. And if it feels right for you, go ahead and take a hand and help to relieve some of that tension there. Just by placing the hand in this area, it helps to soften. Yeah, full breath in here and out. Drop the chin down towards the chest. Again, checking our posture before we move into this pose. Sit up nice and tall, and then we can roll the chin down towards the chest, letting the head be heavy. You might hear some cracks and pops. And as long as they're not painful, know that that's okay. We're just moving these joints. So much gets stuck in the fluidity of our joints if we're not constantly moving and shaking and nourishing them. We can have a lot of tension or emotion that can be stuck in all of our joints. Another inhale here. Exhale, deep breath out. And on the inhale, allow the right shoulder to find its, allow the right ear to find its way above the left. Oh my goodness. Blah, blah, blah. goes in the other way at some point. Finding the head back to center. One more for the neck here. We'll ever so slightly begin to lift the chin up towards the ceiling. Our gaze might draw up and start really small with this movement. Then on the exhale, we'll draw the chin back down to the chest. Inhale. And exhale, finding your way down. And a few rounds of this on your own, using your breath to guide you. Beautiful. Finding the head back up to neutral. Taking a moment to check in with our posture. Very nice. Let's take the legs out and just give them a little shake. And then we'll bring the feet back beneath us. And we're going to bring the arms back behind us. Find the arm of the chair. The hands will meet wherever that is. It doesn't matter which type of chair you're in. Find the arms of the chair, find the back of the chair, and we'll use this to move into a back bend. So before we do anything here, it's really important that we feel both of the feet rooted down, grounded down into the earth below. So shift and move those feet around if you need to. Feel that connection, that stability, moving up into the legs, into the sit bones. From the sit bones, can you sit up nice and tall? And from here, I will invite you to move towards a back bend. So similarly, we can start just by lifting rotating from the inside of our right leg out to the right. So pick up that leg, maybe help it. And it's going to come to the side of the chair here, however it's comfortable. So once we have that right leg settled, then we can shift the hips towards the direction of the right. So we're shifting in our chair, and you'll notice this left leg is just going to want to come in a little bit to feel stable and steady. You have the option, if you have that book or that block there, you can place it under this back foot. So the hips are turned. Hips are square. You can rest the right arm down on the side of the chair for extra support. If you feel ready, begin to experiment with raising that left arm up to whatever degree that you can. Maybe one arm is enough, but if you feel confidence and you feel your balance, you can experiment with drawing the right arm up, both arms up. This is our warrior one here. Deep breath in, use this breath to climb up out of the hips. Use the exhale to soften down through the shoulders without compromising that length that we just gained. One more inhale here. And on the exhale, we're gonna bring the right hand back down to the chair, the left hand back to the hip. So if what we are about to just enter is a version of dancer pose. And so if at any point this does not feel right or comfortable for your body today, know that you do not have to participate. There's always options and it's all up to your own choice. So if you are not participating in this next pose, go ahead and visualize it in your mind and imagine what it might feel like for you. If you are, we can go ahead and bring the left hip down, like we're going to reach for that left ankle. If we can, the left ankle comes up and off the ground, we grab that foot, drawing the heel in towards the buttocks. Getting a nice stretch in the thigh. And again, to whatever degree, maybe the hand does not meet that foot, but maybe it's reaching. And wherever you are, with or without the foot, we'll inhale to lift the head and the heart, inviting a slight back bend in. One more breath in here. If you have the foot, exhale very gently and release. Inhale, sweep the arm up. Exhale, hands to the hip. And we'll find our way back to seated, however you get there. Shift and move around if you need to in your chair. Very nice. Get ready for the other side. So taking this left leg, if you need to help it, go ahead and gather that leg up. We'll bring it towards the left. And then we'll rotate the hips to be square and in line. And as we do that naturally, you'll see that the right leg will come down. Left hand can rest on the back of the chair, grabbing onto it, resting atop, however it is. This right hand can start on the right hip and it can stay here the entire time. This might be the entirety of your pose, and that is so beautiful. Can we practice elongating the spine, sitting up nice and tall? If you'd like to, I'll invite you to rise the arm up to whatever degree. Rest in down here. Exhale, gently release the right foot. Find your way back to seated. One second here.
Okay. It's just getting some notification on my phone. Sorry about that.
All right. Those were our warrior poses for the day. If you're still with me and sitting on the edge of the chair, I will invite you to first with the right leg, take it out to whatever degree to the right. We want that foot to be at a 45 degree angle. And then we'll do the same thing with the left leg. So opening that left leg up. Heel and foot are at a 45 degree angle. Shift and move around if you need to. Very nice. We'll bring left hand onto the hip. The right arm can rise up. And then we'll go ahead and slide that left arm down onto the leg. Moving into a side bend here. Can we lift up the right side of the heart? Notice, how does that change the pose? Breathing into the right side of the body, the right rib cage. Inhale, this is to draw us up, both arms lift up. Exhale, the right arm comes down. Right thigh, we move into a side bend. Very nice. Same thing here. Breathing into the left side of your body, feeling the ribcage expand. Can we lift up through the left side of the heart, opening it? The gaze can be up towards that left hand, down towards the ground, or it can be neutral. So many options to explore. And do what feels right for you. One more inhale here. Exhale. On the next inhale, we'll use our core and both arms to draw ourselves up. And then we'll move through this, these two poses, these two sides, like a wave. Inhale. Exhale, on over to the left. Inhale, draws us up. Exhale to the right. And moving through this at your own rhythm and pace, using your breath to guide you. Finishing up here, finding our way back to center. Let the hands relax down by the side. Draw both of the legs back to center. Move into a forward fold now. So I'll show you two options. One is standing. We're going to stand behind the chair, use the chair as support. The other one will be seated. So first, if you feel like elongate the spine. On the exhale, we'll fold forward once more. The next inhale, bring the hands up to the hips, and with a flat back, we'll find yourself all the way up. Taking a moment here, if you're standing behind the chair, come to seated. Let the hands relax down. Let this forward fold integrate.
Beginning to find Shavasana. So using whatever props that you may need to be comfortable. Pillows, blankets. Get really comfy right now. You can let the hands rest down in the lap. You can rest down by the side. The palms are facing forward. And just like we did in the beginning of the class, I'll invite you now to close down through the eyes or just soften the gaze and let the eyes be heavy. And finishing just how we started. Beginning to bring awareness to your breath. Noticing where the breath is moving throughout the body. Feeling its subtle rhythm. The ebbs and the flows. And moving into a body scan. Again, I'll name different parts of the body from the top of the head all the way down to the toes. And each time you hear me read or say something out, notice if you can relax that area. Starting with the top of the head, can we sit up a little bit taller? And then we'll bring to our attention the forehead, the eyebrows. Can these areas soften? The eyelids, heavy. The space just underneath the eyes, softening. The cheeks and the cheekbones settling down. Feel the left ear, the right ear, both of the ears hearing and listening with the whole body. The left nostril, the right nostril, both nostrils breathing together as one. Unhinge the jaw, let the mouth open slightly. The throat, the neck, let them soften. The heart, feel it beating. The ribs. ribs and the belly. And the shoulder softening down. The upper back, middle back, and the lower back. Feel the hips, sit bones, the shoulders, the upper arms, the elbows, forearms. Let the wrists be heavy, the palms, the fingers. Feel the sensation in them. The hips, the sit bones, the upper legs, knees, lower legs. Feel the ankles, the tops of the feet, the soles of the feet and the toes. Let both of the legs be heavy. Together we'll take a big clearing breath in through the nose. And then a nice big sigh out. Let the body be heavy. Staying here in this space for the next few moments. Read you a quote by the Dalai Lama. A precious human life. Every day, think as you wake up. Today, I am fortunate to have woken up. I am alive. I have a precious human life. I'm not going to waste it. I'm going to use all my energy to develop myself, to expand my heart out to others, to benefit all beings. I am going to have kind thoughts towards others. I am not going to get angry or think badly about others. I am going to benefit others as much as I can. Allowing those words to sink in. And staying here in this final resting pose for as long as you would like. If you are, or when you are ready to begin to wake up, you could begin to wiggle the fingers and the toes. Slowly invite movement back into the neck by rocking the head from side to side. Inhaling the arms up over the head, lengthening out through the legs, a nice big stretch. And then giving yourself a nice big hug. Finding your way back to seated. If you'd like to, bringing the palms of the hands together, rubbing them to create heat and warmth. Go ahead and let those hands rest on the heart. Taking a big breath in and out. I invite you to bow your head down to your heart, honoring our bodies for all of the movement that they made today, thanking our bodies, thanking ourselves for showing up today to this practice, whenever it is that you are experiencing this, thanking each other and all of those who have practiced before, with, and will practice after us. And may these practices of self-care, whatever they are to you, may these practices of self-care continue to benefit our lives and the lives of those around us. Big breath into the heart. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching and joining in, even if you're just catching the end here. Know that these videos do stay up on our Facebook page, so you can utilize them at any time. We also have a whole YouTube channel dedicated to all of our Toivo videos, so you can also look there for more resources. Friday morning, we will be hosting Linda. Linda will be hosting a breath, body, mind class with the Department of Mental Health and Addiction Services and the Department of Energy and Environmental Protection. It will be highlighting Belding Wildlife Management Area. This class will be streamed at 10 in the morning on Friday with Linda Lentini. So we hope that you will join us there. I would say we hope to see you there, but maybe next year it's a hope that we'll be able to bring this series again. So the information for this series is up at the top of our Facebook page. It's called the Summer Wellness Series. Reach out if you have any questions. I hope that everybody enjoys the rest of their Wednesday, and thank you so much for joining.